Hi, Ruth. I know you from up the hill. I can't hear you.
Which hill?
Oh, Point Grey, and I think our kids are the same age. I'm Sherry, and my kids are Matthew and William.
No, we know each other from 10th and Tolmie, just from the neighborhood. I think my kids are younger.
Oh, that's it.
But anyway, I do remember you. We walked together, I think, in a walking group.
Oh, that's it. And now I live down the hill. I call it up the hill, down the hill. It seems to work.
She'll want to be around you guys because it's so good for me.
Good.
So my dancing might be in the chair a bit today. But I just feel the energy and the meditation and the people are all so nice. And I was so sedentary before I began this, and someone mentioned how they get the joy from moving their body. And I thought, oh yeah, joy, you know, it's not a job, you know. Remember to enjoy everything and just make the micro movements if that's all you can do.
Oh, there's Rachel.
Hello, everybody.
Oh, I'll start now.
Hi, welcome, welcome.
Hi, Desirée.
Hi, welcome, Ruby. Oh my gosh, I haven't seen you guys for so long. This is so nice. I've been looking forward to this all week. Welcome, we've got Brenda and Garrick. And I see some beautiful scarves that you've brought. That is so amazing. Allison, Kirsten, Esther. Heather with her beautiful garden. She's always sharing with us. I love it. Cheryl's got her garden with her today too. Love it. Rachel and Ursula are here as our assistants today, and I'll be hosting the masterclass today. It's such a pleasure, privilege, and honor. And I know people will be jumping in as we go along, so warmly welcoming you. Just go ahead and put into the chat one word that describes how you're feeling today. Just the first word that pops into your head. Maybe it's tired, happy, sad, excited, ready to go, enthusiastic. Just go ahead and put that into the chat. I've been a professional dancer for a long, long time. I've had the great pleasure and honor of dancing with dancers dancing through the Martha Graham lineage. You know, my ultimate idol is Martha Graham. And within that style, there's a huge devotion to the feminine, to feminine power, and what's possible with feminine creative power. And you don't just have to be a woman to experience that. You can, of course, be a man and experience that incredible creativity as well. So a lot of what I'm doing is bringing that through so that we can start to even use this in all areas of our life. So how we do something one way is how we do it another. We're not just wanting to help people come to a place of mastery. This is much more about inviting people into community center, community platform, maybe people who have never danced before. And for me personally, community is everything. And I think we've learned that a lot in the last year, that community is so essential to staying inspired, staying healthy, mind, body, spirit, and soul. And it's been my intention that this would stay our sanctuary, that every single Friday you would have a chance just to let go of any worries and cares, at least just for the small amount of time that we are together. And for me also, dance has really been a companion. The heart of what we're up to, it's about transformation. It's about supporting people in emotional shifts that can bring balance, body, mind, spirit, and soul. So we're offering these, you know, empowering tools, finding that connection, and then the students, the participants get to run with it in a way that will serve them best. And it's different for every single person that comes in. When the pandemic hit, I mean, it was, I remember from 1 week to the next, things completely being flipped. It was a 180. So one Friday afternoon, we came into this beautiful space here at Aberthau Mansion, had our usual class. For some reason, a couple weeks before this happened, I bring my laptop thinking, actually, this would be really good if we do this on Zoom at the same time. So for about 2 weeks before, we had people coming in live on Zoom, but also mostly in the space. And it allowed for a completely seamless transition, which I'm just so grateful for, because we didn't miss one class.
And I personally was amazed at how well it worked because we could still talk, have conversations. We would come in there, do our thing. We got, you know, really good at, you know, doing the little functions where we could highlight one person, see them dance, or Rachel and I would do a duet and everyone could watch. So it became this kind of, in a way, more intimate and quiet. And so I am very grateful that we were able to seamlessly pivot during such a difficult time. And then there was a beautiful opportunity for discussions, processing, and integrating around the pandemic specifically, and then exploring themes like isolation. How are we doing? How are we feeling?
Even though we were doing the dance of sort of isolation and non-community, I still felt a connection. I couldn't help it.
I was bringing that feeling into the group, kind of a, you are my garbage bin here. So take it, help me, take that in and take that negative energy, bring it out.
You know, I've always loved to dance, but this class is kind of a level up in terms of how you can access sort of deeper feelings, deeper memories, deeper emotions. And I think that's what I've really appreciated about it. And also the community as well.
This class has been helping me get through the pandemic. You know, it gives me something to look forward to every Friday. And it puts me in a good mood every Friday, you know, because it's easy to get into, a negativity because of the pandemic, because we're kind of cut off from doing regular things. And you don't really want to get into a negative pattern. So every Friday, it's like this kind of offsets getting into any negativity and makes me a few positive.
I just want to confess to being a Zoom skeptic in the beginning. I know, you know, I have to congratulate you, Desirée, that you were on the forefront of using Zoom. You started to use Zoom even before we locked down in anticipation of what actually did happen. Mm-hmm. And, you know, nothing beats being in person, but I've found that, you know, as time goes on, using Zoom has been more, you know, has been more than an excellent substitute.
You know, it's sort of like this class sets kind of a very interesting ambience. We have the music, we have the intention, we have the regular meeting of our group, and we also have kind of the meditation and kind of a therapeutic outcome, at least certainly for me, that is very powerful and has sustained me through this year of loads of grief and change in my own life. Take a minute every day.
We chase the shadows far. We're better doing things together. We're stronger doing things together. It's more fun and it's more effective. So if we can come together through a dance workshop session, come together in commune and unity and community, and we're sending positive energy out to the world, I think that's one of the most powerful things that we can do. So we become like an antenna sending out waves of healing, light, energy, frequencies that are the opposite of fear. It's about faith, trust, and belief that everything's going to be okay, and that we can actually change our mind and perhaps start to do things differently that will support all of humanity, the healing of the wounds of humanity, and also healing the earth. I think dancers dance because they want to fly, they want to leap, they want to have a sense of freedom, and there's nothing better than that sense of flow and presence and being in the moment that you get when you're on stage and everything clicks. If there's a silver lining or a blessing to the pandemic, it's
bringing people back together and reprioritizing community and connection.
Shining so bright in a world we know is gonna be all right. Yeah, we know the world is gonna be all right. 'Cause we got all these tiny lights.
I know you won't let me down. I can't tell by the vibe that's been around our house. I got some real questions to ask you now. Do you think we might change?